In your cell, you have all of your DNA, which is contained in the nucleus. And this nucleus is surrounded by a membrane that we call the nuclear envelope. And our lab has been very interested in the dynamics of that membrane and how that may affect the ability of the nucleus to function and also its relationship to cancer. So one of the hallmarks of cancer, and this also happens in normal cells, is that sometimes you get what's called a lagging chromosome. So a piece of DNA gets left behind. And after the cell goes out of mitosis and is done dividing, this piece of DNA will form its own nucleus in addition to all the rest of the chromatin, which is forming what we call the primary nucleus. And this little guy we call the micronucleus. These micronuclei have some problems. Basic nuclear functions seem to not be working right in them, but it's never been clear about why that's happening. And so what we've done is we found that if you look at what's happening to the nuclear membrane, we find that instead of maintaining the micronucleus as a little DNA compartment, it's actually rupturing, causing that DNA to, instead of being in a nucleus, to be stuck in the cytoplasm. And that means that we're losing all the functions from it. Interesting part is that sometimes this kind of stranded DNA in the cytoplasm gets reincorporated back into the main genome. But if you think about it, this is really a bad idea because this DNA has been, you know, heavily damaged, maybe hasn't replicated, hasn't really been working correctly, and now it's back in the rest of the nucleus, and you get rearrangements and mutations that can lead to increased cell division and cancer. This is basically one of the first experiments that shows a link between dynamics of the nuclear membrane and something that may be leading to cancer progression. So this gives us another tool that we can use to try to affect the course of the cancer by targeting the nuclear membrane. And second of all, the things that we've found can be applicable to diagnostics for certain types of tumors or how far your tumor has progressed that we think could lead to a more accurate diagnosis. Now we have a very easy way to identify micronuclei, genomic instability in solid tumors very quickly and very easily.